Why do you have to lose? You're living in poverty. Your schools are no good. You have no jobs. 58% of your youth is unemployed. What the hell do you have to lose?
Things were quieter for Trump's Democratic rival Hillary Clinton this week, but she still had her share of controversy.
Earlier, Claudia and I spoke about the candidates and all of its political news with E.J. Dionne of the Washington Post, the Brookings Institution, and Eliana Johnson, Washington editor of the National Review.
So, Eliana, I want to start with you, because the National Review has made its opinions known throughout this campaign season about Donald Trump. But the introduction of a new voice in the Trump campaign, with the head of Breitbart News, Steve Bannon, joining that campaign, introduces a voice from the media landscape you know well. How did you read this voice being added here?
You know, the campaign came out insisting this was not a shakeup, but an expansion of the senior leadership team. I think of Paul Manafort, who was the campaign chairman, with his resignation today, we now have confirmed that this is indeed a shakeup. So we now have Steve Bannon, who was the chairman and CEO of Breitbart.com, taking on the position of CEO of the Trump campaign. And I actually don't think this is going to be an enormous change for the Trump campaign of the essential DNA of the campaign. What we really had before was Paul Manafort pushing back against Trump, trying to shape him and mold him into a president, and Trump really chafing at that. What Breitbart was doing in the media, they incubated the primary voters for Trump with a real nationalist, populist, anti-immigration message, and Trump was able to jump to the head of the parade when he entered the campaign last year. And so I think that Bannon going out of the campaign, what it really is a shedding of pretenses that Trump was ever going to pivot and become a different candidate in the general election. And now we know all the journalists who were so excited to write that story about the new Donald Trump will have to abandon the idea that Trump is going to become anybody different in a general election than he was in the primary.
EJ, we've got Eliana giving up on the word pivot, which I welcome, totally overused. How are you feeling?
I mean, the new Trump, same as the old Trump. I mean, I broadly agree with that, but I think there is a radicalism to Steve Bannon and to Breitbart that ought to disturb all kinds of people, including conservatives. I mean, they have given a really strong voice on the conservative side to the so-called very extreme right, like nationalism, and our own Republicans were saying, yes, let's take the Confederate flag down in South Carolina. Right now, we're saying, oh, that's the American tradition represented by this flag. And so I think there will be a radicalization of where we have policies, but there will also be limited radicalizations of the Confederate represent, make switch for politics with gentlemen. And so maybe that's what Trump is going to go anyway, but I think this is going to pop it up for Trump even more.
You know, Manafort's resignation this morning came after the Associated Press last night reported that Manafort's lobbying firm received payments to advocate in the United States for pro-Russian Ukrainian officials, which some legal experts have said may have crossed a legal line. Eliana, we knew that Manafort did this sort of work, but it never seemed to bother the Trump campaign before. Why now?
You know, I think what happened was really this was the excuse for Trump to layer Paul Manafort and put Steve Bannon above him and Kellyanne Conway, the new campaign manager, below him. And Paul Manafort simply isn't a number two. I had a Trump aide tell me a couple weeks ago that he believed that what Trump would do is put somebody above Manafort, and that would be the signal for Manafort to step down. This guy wasn't going to report to anybody. I don't think Trump had any problem at all with Manafort's associations. And if you look at Corey Lewandowski, who preceded Manafort as campaign manager, and Steve Bannon, who came after him, they all really have a sort of bullying, thuggish way about them. And, you know, I don't think it's unfair to say Trump has a type. But what happened was a drip, drip, drip of news reports that about Manafort's ties that gave Trump the excuse he needed to get rid of somebody whose style he was rubbing up against and didn't like anyway.
Right, and polls didn't help.
I'm sure, right?
And also, I think that, first of all, we can now judge all Trump campaign statements by the Manafort standard.